Folks, this is Ben, and I'm with LearnHotDogs.com and HotDogCartStore.com, standing here again in front of the Big Dog Cart, and I have a question for you, and some other stuff for you. Today, we got several questions, and I'm going to get to everybody's questions that I can, and also, we're going to be giving away, as promised, we're going to be giving away the Wacka Hot Dog. Which is my fancy name for the toaster oven that cooks the buns and the hot dogs at the same time. So somebody who liked and shared, that's all you had to do is like and share the post, is going to win that. And that is over on the I Love Street Food Vending Facebook page. Okay? So Heather will be giving me the winner here in a little bit. But for the time being, I'm going to answer some questions. So today, what I'm going to want to answer is, here's the email, and I'll read this to you. It says, I know if you went through with, let's see. I know this is an old post. I'm not sure if you went through with the problem with having someone run your cart is having to trust them 200% as this is a cash business and money can disappear without you even knowing it. Let me stop right there. One, it's gotten to be less of a cash business. There's still a lot of cash, okay? But now most vendors take the Square or the PayPal swiper or some type of thing so that they can get the payment, because a lot of people don't carry cash. I never carry cash anymore. I've always got my debit card, and I go to Ace Hardware and I swipe my debit card, or wherever I am, swipe my debit card. And so if somebody only accepts cash, I have no way of buying their goods. And so I would always recommend a vendor doing that. But back to the question is having to trust someone in the business. You know, you've hired somebody. Let's say you've expanded. You've gotten your second cart or your third cart and you're hiring people now. Or maybe your first cart and you've got somebody running it 2 days a week. How do you trust them? Well, you don't. The nice part is if you do your records on a yellow pad even, you don't have to have some fancy fandangled software. You do just normal record keeping on a piece of paper. How many hot dogs did I give you this morning? I gave you 100. You've given me 16 back. That means 84 hot dogs. Then at the very least, okay, I should have whatever the cost of the dog is times 84. Plus the drinks, chips, whatever, you know, you count. It's all a matter, it's an inventory. You know how much you gave them. If you gave them enough for 100 meals, okay, which would be 200 hot dogs and 100 bags of chips and 100 drinks, if you did just that, you'd know if you got enough money. Now, there's going to be a couple incidences. There's always going to be, I dropped this, or I put too much mustard on Bob's hot dog and he didn't want it, so I made him a new one and I threw that one away. There's going to be some loss. That's called shrinkage. That is honest shrinkage. But it's okay. But you show up and they have nothing left or very little left and they got $50 to show for it, you know there's theft. So you don't have to trust them. You have a check and balance system that's easy to do. Easy as pie to do. It's not rocket science. It's not got to have several barcode labels on every hot dog or anything. You just know, okay, I'm giving you 100 hot dogs, or I'm giving you 200 hot dogs today, or I'm giving you 400 hot dogs today. I know a guy that he just writes down whatever he delivers to each food truck that day. He's got 4 food trucks in the Nashville, Tennessee area. Now, let me pull this back up. Let's see. So that answers that question, I hope. I hope that helps you with that question. The next one. Here, I'm going to read this email to you because it's a little bit convoluted. And I'm going to stop wherever I need to answer the question that's proposed in it. I haven't become a vendor yet, but I have been listening to your program for the past 4 months. Gathering all the free information I can until I'm ready to buy a cart, which it will probably be one of yours. That's awesome. I was wondering why you never seem to talk or answer an email from anyone besides the vendors on the East Coast or in southeastern states. except for once in Minnesota or Indiana that I heard on your show. Where are all the 14,000 vendors that you talk about that have signed up over the years, since I never hear you speak with any of them or receive their emails? I'm not doubting you, but don't anybody out of Tennessee, North Carolina, Florida, and Texas ever contact you? Well, the Sunday we had the vendor from Tennessee. North Carolina 2 weeks ago, I filmed a vendor 3 weeks ago while I was in North Carolina. Filmed a vendor on his day spot and then on his night spot and interviewed him. Florida, we just did an email from a vendor in Florida. And Texas, I have personally about 200 customers, 300 roughly in Texas. And it just depends on who emails me. Now, I get a buttload of emails every day. But I have to, like, if somebody sends me something, like the email I sent out yesterday, I asked them permission before I send out a copy of their email. So if they don't respond to my asking for permission or they tell me no, then I don't do it. So I don't have a lot of choice there, and I don't control who calls into the show. So people call in from, you know, I may get 10 calls in one show from Tennessee and none from North Carolina or none from Florida. But then the next show, I may get 6 from Florida and 2 from Georgia and none from Tennessee and North Carolina. I never know. You know, we've had shows where we talk to vendors in Pennsylvania, vendors in Missouri, vendors in fact, we just did a show, a vendor in Missouri and in Pennsylvania. So I never know. It's not like I control that. It's just how it comes in and who gives me permission to share. This says, I live in California where they only let vendors sell hot dogs, Polish dogs, brats, tamales off a hot dog cart. That's a lot of stuff you can serve. That's cool. You can sell other items like the ones you always are talking about on your radio show if you are a vendor with a truck or a brick and mortar. Well, yeah, a truck is a commercial kitchen inside, so anything goes there. But you're talking about Polish dogs, brats, tamales. That's awesome, because a lot of states don't even allow tamales. So that's freaking awesome. It's why I have a video called Why Just Hot Dogs. That Why Just Hot Dogs video explains why just hot dogs. All 50 states allow them, and it's easy. It's simple. It's low cost, and everybody likes them, you know, pretty much. So it's a go-to meal. It's a great meal, great value, and when you're cooking it fresh, like here on the Big Dog Cart, it's going to taste good every time. And you're delivering a good quality meal for a value, a good price. Next thing he says, you talk about checking on the codes, but how do I go about doing that? I have a video on that in my free training section at the top of hotdogcartstore.com or learnhotdogs.com or in my ebook or my paperback book. It's in there, but for free, you can go to learnhotdogs.com and I tell you how to check the codes. In fact, I actually use I filmed my screen as I check for codes in different states, so you can see how to go about doing that. And I even give you an alternative method that's even easier. So that's answered there. Besides the above questions, I think your programs are terrific, and I've gotten a lot of information about being a vendor. I don't know how to go about asking questions about the hot dog business except by using email. That's a great way to do it. Keep up the good work, and when I'm able to afford to buy my hot dog cart, I will be checking on the ones you have listed for sale, blah, 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 including the ones, blah. One last question. How can these vendors sell hundreds of hot dogs each day when it takes 7 to 10 minutes to boil one? Now, think about this, folks. And I know if you're a vendor and you're watching this, you already know the answer to this. You already know, okay? You don't boil one dog at a time. You know, if I'm at a busy location, I got 3 pans going. That's 160 dogs I've got going at any given time. If I'm at a slow location, just an average daily location, I may have 30, 30, and 30. That's 90 dogs at a time, okay? I may just have one pan with 30 or 45 dogs in it. But at the very least, I got 20 or 30 dogs in a pan. And they all get ready at the same time. So I'm not cooking one dog at a time, 7 to 10 minutes each dog. hopefully I misunderstood that question, but how long does it take the added water to boil before you can sell, shall we say, 100 or more each, 4 to 6 hours a day? One, you shouldn't be working 6 hours a day. Most vendors work about 4 hours a day, and including cleanup, because we're there about 11:30 to about 2 every day, plus our cleanup, so that's about 4 hours. How many dogs? I always have a goal. I want to sell 100 meals a day. That's 200 hot dogs. That's about $600 a day for me, and not counting the extra waters and extra drinks that you'll sell, period. My drinks are my top sellers all the time. People come up, they don't want just one. They'll drink one maybe, then they come back and get another one. So, so a $600-$700 a day is realistic. Says, did I miss something? Thanks for your time to read my email. Your friend. Okay. So, he's in California. I'm not mentioning names because I didn't get his permission to. So, there's a California one for the person that asked me if I ever talked to vendors in other states. So, that one's done. Now, let me check. Heather's got more stuff for me, I think. Okay. Hopefully. Heather should have a link right down below, okay? If you would like, till Sunday night at midnight, Eastern Standard Time, you can get my book, okay, for more than 50% off and download it instantly if you'd like, or you can get the paperback, doesn't matter. So click that link, share it with a friend. If you have a friend that's considering the business, probably the very least you'll spend in your life to get as much information as I give you in that book, because it is not like a storybook. It's a book that teaches you. It's a book that walks you step by step. It's a book that shows you how I made $8,000 my first month, more than, and how I made over $120,000 my first year with not knowing nothing. But I learned a lot. And then when I wrote the book, I put that in there, so that you can avoid those learning curves. You can go straight to the point. Okay. So there's a coupon code she's going to give you. If you'll look down, and there may be one above later. After this goes off of live, there may be a coupon code above, but there's definitely one below that you'll want to use. and it's only good till Sunday night. Winner of the Wacka Hot Dog machine, the awesome freaking machine, and this is through random selection through a software that Heather's using for me. It's Bruce Bowers. Bruce Bowers. Bruce, what you'll need to do is email me, ben@learnhotdogs.com. ben@learnhotdogs.com with your name, address, and phone number. I have to have all of those to ship this to you. And it will be shipped directly to you, and you'll have it in 3 days probably. Okay? Brand new, spanking brand new, in the box with a warranty. Never been touched. Okay? So, Bruce Bowers, congratulations. Next week, we're giving away something else. I'm going to tell you about it Monday. Okay? And then Friday, we'll give it away. So, stay tuned, because people are learning stuff here, and I'm getting emails, and I'm getting text messages, and I'm getting SpeakPipe messages. People are learning here, and this is helping people. Some of this stuff may be old hat to you, but you never know what I'm going to come across. If there's something you want me to cover, please let me know. Please let me know. Post it in the comments. Email us. Message us here on the Facebook, and we'll answer it. Or go over. Right now, the best way for you to win anything is to go over to Street Food Vending. I Love Street Food Vending. On Facebook, just type in, I Love Street Food Vending, and you're going to get it. Go check us out there. That's for everybody. And that's where we're going to eventually be posting these videos, every time. If you've missed anything recently, if you've missed anything at all, please go to learnhotdogs.com and grab it. Heather's posting up every day after the show, any links we give, any tips we give, she's putting it up there for you. So that'll help you out. I hope it helps you out. I want to hear from you. And congratulations again to Bruce Bowers. And I gave you the instructions. Hopefully, if you know Bruce and he's not on here, let him know that he won. Okay? so that I can get his information and get him shipped out. I love you guys, and I cannot wait. I hope you have a great weekend. I may be back sporadically through the weekend, too. I've got a lot of stuff to do here at the house. My wife has a to-do list for me. But I look forward to seeing you Monday either way. Go over and check out the site, facebook.com/ILoveStreetFoodVending. Check that out. Also, check out and get the book. If you're considering this, you can. This will set you free. Set you free. Check it out. I love you. See you later. Bye.